And welcome back. Coming up, we've got music from the Manic Street Preachers, but now let's chat to the boys themselves. Please welcome James Dean and Nikki from the Manic Street Preachers.
James, how are you doing?
Hi guys, how are you doing?
Nice to meet you. Thank you. Lovely to have you. We've been really excited all week. You guys are complete icons to have on the show. Does it feel weird when people talk about you like that and it has been 25 years? Does it feel kind of slightly strange or does it feel it's been even longer?
It feels odd that me and James were in school with each other since the age of four.
That is a long time. You haven't killed each other yet. That is a long time to know someone.
I haven't come close, really.
I just bent my finger back once.
I did, yeah. And he's told me, kind of like, you know, he's criticised my dress since many, many, many times.
Really? So, you look pretty sharp tonight, boys, I have to say.
I made an effort, but he kind of, it was a three-line whip with him, you know?
Oh, really? Is he like, you know, the Gokwan of the band?
Yeah, guys, amazing stats. 8 top 10 albums, 15 top 10 singles, and you've been going for 25 years. What keeps you going?
We just genuinely still love music and being in a band, and it's our greatest form of expression. It's the way we can get all our kind of emotions into 3.5 minutes and project it to the world. You know, there's just no finer feeling than creating something, you're on the radio and someone coming up to you in the street and saying that song meant something to him. You know, it's just amazing.
And you clearly are still so passionate about the music, that's why you're here, but the industry has changed so much within the last 25 years. And I'm sure it's a question you have been asked, but for you guys, has the introduction of the internet and downloads, you know, how has that affected you as a band? Are you happy?
It's kind of changed it, you know, and we just accept that change. But it is strange, you know, when we first started, you know, they were still having cassette singles. Mm-hmm. You know, we're a band that stretches from the age of the Betamax to the download, which is quite rare.
Which is cool.
You know, but it's kind of, yeah, everything does feel as if it's completely and utterly changed.
Because I think as a band as well, I'm assuming it was all about getting that record deal. It was about fighting, whereas bands nowadays can really, they can cut out the middleman with the record company if they really want, go online. And they can be much more in control at that time. You know, I suppose it was all down to the record companies for you guys.
No, I mean, it's kind of myth, basically. If you're on a major record company and you haven't got any brains or ideas, then they manipulate you. Mm-hmm. But if you're like us and you want to be in control, it's easy. You know, and we've been on the same record label for 20 years. They've never forced us to do anything we don't want to do.
Yeah.
Because we just say no.
And you've obviously had your fans there for all those years as well. There was a wee buzz around the office today, I'll tell you the truth, when a lot of the folk heard that you were coming in. Have you always been well received in Scotland?
Oh, we've had some of the best nights ever. I mean, the Barrowlands in particular. And
it's an amazing venue.
Just if I could take that rubber floor home with me, the way people can bounce
it
up
really
and down.
It really just does bounce, doesn't it? It's scary.
It's the only venue that kind of like that you go around Britain and you go back to certain places and places change over the years. But Barrowlands is the only. The dress room is exactly the same as your first.
The smell is
exactly the same.
The kind of gas fire.
You know, kind of like. But also, we did a gig in Gurrock Bay right at the start in 1991, and right. That was tasty.
Tell us about it. What actually happened?
Like, even the seagulls were aggressive. I mean, I had a bag of chips. There were none left. I got attacked by seagulls. It was like a Hitchcock
film.
They happy slap.
These seagulls happy slap if you're eating.
We got syringed with cider. So there was these mad fans down in front, and they had syringes. I hope it was cider anyway.
No.
And it was these great pictures. James has got a bloody nose, and we all got our tops off. But that is, you know, genuine excitement when you're 20.
And actually, getting syringed with cider in Scotland is how we get one of our 5 a day. It's the only way it happens to us. So, Casey, don't you be cheeky. Now, what about the Scottish fans themselves? Have they been really good with you?
I mean, one of our best ever gigs was in the SECC. You know, it just felt like the crowd were levitating. You know, I mean, when you get those kind of nights, you know, they're unforgettable. It's better than any drug, not that I would know. You know, it's something that kind of like you come off stage and you generally kind of like crestfallen because you just know that you've got, you know, you can have this massive come down after that moment. And like I say, we've had amazing. The first time we played King Tut's was just beautiful. Barrowlands is just this soap. We played there about 11 times and they've all been amazing. Wow. You know.
Yeah. Let's talk about this album that's coming out just now. This is a collection. It's 38 singles on here.
Yeah, that's here.
It's spanning from Generation Terrorist all the way through to Postcards for a Young Man. Is it quite something when you guys look at this body of work that you have? I mean, this is just singles that came off these albums.
Yeah.
I mean, is it nice? Was it lovely for you guys to go back and kind of revisit some of that music?
It does evoke some, you know, some real kind of beautiful memories, some sad memories as well. Yeah. But, you know, 38 singles in 21 years of the band. I think we don't like to look back and reflect. You know, you get really scared if you're in a band. You think, oh my God, that's over, we're a museum. But I think for once we genuinely feel pretty proud of it. you know, that we've had all those hits and, you know,
and
still,
you should.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a bit weird seeing some of the A-cuts from the early 90s and stuff.
Do you know, we did in the office, we went back and looked through some of the pictures and stuff today, and there were some special looks. She's always looked great, but there was some...
My blonde skin, it didn't work out.
And if you want to see some haircuts from the 90s, go back to Gourock tonight.
You'll see that.
We've still got them. Trust me in that.
Okay. All right, guys, we're going to let you go. What are you going to be playing for us tonight?
We're going to be playing Design for Life, and This is the Day.
All right, please give it up for the magic. We won't let you guys get organised to play Magic Features, everyone. Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys. Okay, well, while the boys are getting ready, we've got just enough time to remind you that the fun doesn't stop here. The show will continue over on the net at 9 o'clock with more music and more chat from our guests. And remember, you can find us at stv.tv/thehour.
Please join us next week when our guests include the wonderful Erasia and the star of Mrs. Brown's Boys, Brendan O'Carroll. But for now, taking us over to the web and the end of the show is the wonderful Manic Street Preachers with their new single, This Is The Day.